Here, Riley, Day 9 takes definitely a slightly scenic route to victory.
Slightly scenic, mate. He's driving across from one coastline to the other on his way to victory here. Look at this. So you've got a Vraska ultimate, and then we're going to see an Angrath downtick, but he's made a flaw in his calculations, Denis.
Yeah, that Crackling Drake is a 0-4 on Sean's side of the battlefield, but ever adaptive, he can just Ras his Contempt Vraska with her own Contempt to get that thing up to the one damage he needs.
She's still dealing with some real self-esteem issues, but I tell you who isn't, and that is Day 9, because he is getting it done. Look at the smile on his face. He's a very happy chap.
On purpose. We didn't make a mistake.
Riley, here we have Savantir caught out in the middle of a storm.
Yes, indeed, and without an umbrella as well, Denis. He is getting torn apart by this thousand-year storm, well into its fifth or sixth century by this stage. Shocks to the face as well, and I mean, on 8, is there any chance he could survive? Not with another shock.
No, but here's the thing, Riley. They say lightning doesn't strike twice in the same place.
This is demonstrably false. It's a complete myth. Not only lightning rods exist at the top of skyscrapers, this sort of thing. There was a guy called Roy Sullivan, who was a US park ranger. He got hit by lightning 7 times and survived each strike.
Well, I think Scott Cullen might be taking that record from Roy today.
Well, okay, look at this. Some classic BM here, getting rid of these drakes. I love this. This is top-level BM from M. Malkov here, removing the creatures, giving Scott the sweats before the final strike arrives to just ruin his day. We better update the Wikipedia page of notable people struck by lightning several times.
Yeah, you got it.
Riley, we've got big plays on both sides of the table here in this one.
Yes, indeed. Very late stage of the game. Only 16 cards left in the library for our valiant hero here. And, oh, Jarlino looking to put this game in the books. A massive Sylvan Awakening. And that's going to be followed up, Denis, with a Rallying Roar. This is an attack for 36.
It's not quite lethal, but it's pretty close when your opponent's on 44. But unfortunately for him, there is an ace up this guy's sleeve, and that is this monstrous settler egg.
I've seen some big settles in my time, Denis, but I don't think I've ever seen one quite as big as this. You know my favorite part as well? No basics left to search for.
Yeah, absolutely not. That is just the classic 15 for one, I guess, if you count the Sylvan Awakening and the Rallying Roar. Riley, do you know reaction gifs?
Yes.
There are these things people post, the little faces and things to react to situations. And I think Jim Davis is about to give us a pretty good one here.
Yeah, I mean, we're getting a 2-for-1 here, because look at that one. The Goblin Chain Whirler into a footboard of 2-2-3-6. Oh, what's happened here? Oh, I don't know. I can't believe it.
Look at his face. That is a high-status Chain Whirler just machine-gunning down Jim's board. And, oh, he can't believe it.
Machine-gunning, mate. He's whirling around RPGs, never mind chains.
That is just wanton destruction. Riley, Caleb here is in a pretty commanding position. He's got a Verdurous Gearhulk, he's got a Crater of Behemoth, he's got a pretty big Forest in play, and a Nissa about to ultimate. It's tough to imagine how things could go wrong from here.
Yeah, look, it's looking pretty good for old Caleb, although it's hard to imagine an attack with a Crater Hoof that doesn't involve lethal. His opponent on one life, and this is his last bite at this particular cherry here, Denis.
Absolutely, his opponent's going to have to pull something pretty special out of the bag. And a Zealous Conscripts is theoretically a pretty good start to that.
Not exactly, though. I mean, the Nissa can't ultimate. There's not really a whole lot that it can do here. Copy a Crater Hoof, get in for 5. I mean, Caleb's on a cool 20. I don't see what could go wrong here.
Yeah, single Crater Hoof definitely not going to do it, but his opponent has more than one Crater Hoof in store.
Look at this. Saheeli Ray making a second Crater Hoof. Can it come in for 500,000,000,000 instead of just the 5? And that should be enough to put this one in the books, Denis.
That is a swift cut down from 20 to 0 for Caleb. Actually, from 20 to negative 21.
Let's be specific.
Thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. If you have your own submissions to MTG Top 5, either tweet them at us with hashtag MTG Top 5 or email them in to submissions@channelfireball.com.